Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of ARK. So, ooh, but they're shooting something. Okay. According to this turret, this trilobite has been claimed by someone. I think the turret's just stupid. Anyways, now, or today, rather, we are building the wall. Now, this wall, it's mainly to protect against T-Rexes and Gigas and stuff. People, as you can see, can walk right through. But they won't really be a problem because I plan on setting up a lot of these turrets. And normal turrets to take out all, like, stragglers that walk in. And so, but I'm doing some building in 3 high. Hopefully that keeps out Gigas. I'm not sure if it's 3 or 4 high for them. I'll look it up later though. And so yeah. I've been encountering a few problems though. I'm not sure if I could show you here. Yeah. For some reason it's saying that I can't build a structure here. Even though if I take this out of the snap, I could easily build a structure there. So I had to kind of build around that. That's why you see like this pattern here where it's like one forward more and one back. I don't think a T-Rex can walk through that. And actually, yeah, looking at its dimensions compared to the gaps, I don't think it'll go through that. As you can see though, completely Rex proof. And it's made of stone, and I don't think Rexes can bite through stone, so they'll need to use explosives to get through. And the less of those they have at entrance, the better for me. Although flyers will just go straight through. But that'll be why I have a ton of turrets. So, I'll continue on the building. Oh yeah, also, I got a whatchamacallit. A beaver. And I tamed up an overraptor. So I can get more eggs. I noticed that my pteranodon actually laid an egg even though it didn't have any sort of mate boost or anything. So hopefully I can get a few spinoids since the spino is a female. Alright, so a lot more eggs, full beans, and base building. Anyways, I'm gonna build some more of the wall and I'll cut back in a second. So yeah, I'll be back. Hopefully soon. Okay, so just checking in again. Ooh, it dropped a spawn. So I built the walls all the way around, but at the back there's still just 1 high, so I need to finish that. I checked, and a 3 high wall can close a Giga for taming, or at least that's what the wiki suggests as a method of capturing it for taming. So I'm assuming that means I can keep it out as a 3 high wall. Although, what can happen is it could glitch out and jump over the walls somehow. That might happen, especially because these are pillars and their height's kind of wacky, you know. But hopefully it keeps it out. If not, then I read that only 2 or 3 rockets can put into its rage mode, which would be pretty good to turn the enemy's Gigas against themselves. I'm not sure if I showed this, but in one of the bases that I saw, it's across the map, so I'm not too worried about it raiding me. But they have like 3 or 4 Gigas. So hopefully they don't raid me. So yeah, I will finish making the pillars and I'll be back once I have this finished. So yeah, be right back. Alright, so I've got the wall up, and it looks pretty good so far. Actually, that corner could be smoothed out a bit. Oh well. If I replace these with metal pillars, then I'll do that then. I do plan on having the traditional, like, behemoth gate wall, maybe surrounding the entire island and a bit of the water. But I think for the main base section, this would be good. It could be like several layers of city walls. Now what I'm trying to do here is make a turret platform, but the Pteranodon being the stupid dumb bird it is, it's not landing on that, so I'm going to try to slowly fly in and jump off. Alright, that actually worked. Alright, I guess it's just going to stay there and bat me off with its wings. Anyways, can I place these where I want them? No. Can I make stone ramps? Shoot, it doesn't look like I can. I'll build a wooden ramp and see if I can replace that. This is really just a proof of concept. Oh, I need a bit more wood. And I just told my bird to go away. Yay! Let's see, can I build a wall? I can build one of these walls. I need two of them, though. Those I don't think will work. Yeah, I need to go back down to get some more walls. Do I have any walls built up already? Yes, I do. Alright, so can I place a wall out like that? Nope, I cannot. Well, I'm gonna need walls all the way down anyways. I'm gonna try placing a wooden ramp though, because I might just have to replace it with metal ramps, and that'll be fine once I have everything set up. So I'll make several of these up right now. Seven. Yeah, that's gonna be good. So what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to place the plant species X turrets on these ramps. I just want to see if the game will allow me to do that. And if it does, then I can make little turret outposts. Alright, I guess I'm gonna have to do this trick again. And he's too fast. Of course. Ow. Where'd he go? There we go. Okay. Can I place large crop plots onto these? Oh, shoot, that's backwards. Come on. The ramp, please. Well, I just have to chop this myself. Oh well, I'll just test this one up here. Okay, it doesn't look like it wants to place on that. It's strange, it wants to place on those. If you go up here, you can see that every once in a while it snaps onto the ceiling. So I was thinking maybe if I use roofs, then that could work. Let's try that one last time. So I do kind of want to get this to work. Ah, screw it, we'll be sideways. Wait, I had it for a second. Alright. It doesn't appear that I could do that, or just prefers placing on the ground a lot more. So there goes the whole epic sloped tower idea. But I could still use these towers, so I'm gonna keep them. I just need to get back up there, so I'll find a way to repurpose these towers, and I'll be back with you guys in a bit. Okay, so I think I've come up with a good tower design. So it's going to have four of the plant species X turrets around it, and maybe an electric turret at the top, and that would shoot down any sort of rockets that are fired at this, or anything like that, that could destroy the tower in one hit. Oops, T-Rex is stuck. So I'm gonna bring this guy back, and I'll make a few more of these, like, bases. These, like, base structures around. And this is going to be where I put a generator. I don't know if I have enough resources to spare to make several of them. I believe it's here. So, actually no, those are really cheap. I'm gonna make a few of those then. I can almost make one right now, actually. I just need, well, actually. I'll just test on camera if the generator is good. So I'm going to need these two things as well. I don't think it's going to need these vertical panels. Two of them rather. It's four metal. Right. I also need 15 wood. And I didn't see how many electrons, so I'm just gonna grab some. Try wiring this up now. If I can get into my own door. There we go. Yeah, looks like this will fit. Although I do need to step out of the room to do this. Is it poking out? No, okay, good. Am I placing this here? So I'll quickly, I might demolish a wall to be able to place that. So, might be close enough right now, not really sure. Oh god. Okay, here we go. Let's see, can I see the wire poking through this once the rubble clears? Actually, wait. Here we go. This is definitely close enough. See, can I get on the other side? Actually, no, that's the inner side. It should be safer. And we can just rebuild that wall. Okay, so now all I need to do is load that up with fertilizer, wait for it to rain again, and fill the generator up with oil, and then it'll all be ready for when I plant and place the turrets on the day of the wars. I've got these turrets here that I just placed thinking that it would be helpful. I'll just leave them there because there's no harm in doing it. And what I'm also going to do is place these. Now these, I heard, will kick off the rider to any sort of dino. So I'm gonna place these around at the turrets, which is where I think they'll go. Like maybe one in the bushes here. It'll knock off the rider and then they'll be shot by the turrets. Actually, I'll probably place them farther back, like maybe here or so, in these spots. So yeah, I'll continue with these, with the base defense, and then I'll bring you guys back later on once I have some more stuff to place, or something else to show you guys. Okay, so I built up a second tower, and I made the electronic stuff for two more. And I can easily make some more, I just don't have the patience to right now. I want to put a turret down, one of these structures down at least every 10 pillars. Well, actually, however far this distance is, that's a bit more than 10 pillars. Anyways, those won't be my only defense, I'll definitely have a few more smaller things. But that could be a good medium-sized thing, I might have a big, huge turret placed in the center, I'm not sure. Anyways, I was just about to do something and I'm forgetting. Oh yeah, we can make the turrets now. The actual metal turrets. Oh, but first I want to get more gasoline. I want to check how much each gas does, or how long each piece of gas lasts in these generators. So I'm thinking maybe only like 100 gas in a generator. An uncommon crossbow, I'll keep it. I don't really think it's necessary to have too much more than at max 100, maybe like 70 or 2, because it's only for the weekend that I have to keep those generators on. So I'm just going to gather up some oil here. This is still sadly my best method of gathering oil. I need to maybe get an RG, then I can fly that down to the, you know, like, ice island. Oh, I can't pull up my map on this guy. Anyways, there's a big source of oil on the ice island and on the volcano island. That's really the biggest sources of oil I've ever found on this map, so I think that'll be where I have to get big shipments of oil from. Not shipments, loads, you know. And for that I'm needing RG, or else it'll just be wasting my time. With the Pteranodon, I think this is faster, because I'll have to take multiple trips with that. And all that sort of stuff. And this, I like it because it's just so close and convenient. Actually, I just remembered, I still need to put my behemoth gates in. I think I clicked off screen. Still need to put in some behemoth gates. I'll figure out where to place those in a second. Just need to get more oil. I'm also going to need to start stockpiling some explosives so I can bust open some bases. Most bases I've seen are made of stone, so it'll be pretty easy to go into. I'm not sure what dinos to take with me, if any. Maybe like a Pteranodon to get out of there quickly, because I have that really fast Pteranodon. I might also get an Archie, in case I want to carry a lot. Thanks for the hide. I think this is good enough. Oh wait, that was an O. So we can start firing up this gasoline and then create the turrets and then place the behemoth gates. Oh. I had some gasoline going already. I'll put half of that in there and half in here. Oh, I had even more gas going. Okay, now I gotta rebalance it. Half in here and half in here. I think my beaver has some extra wood on it. Yeah, I need to move this in. Is that an egg? No, that's just... that's just the Spino's toe. Lots of dimorph eggs. I think I need a better way to get fertilizer, because this way is pretty slow. I think maybe I'll go for one of those bugs. I don't remember what they're called off the top of my head, but they're in the caves. I might get one of those. I'm not entirely sure yet. They're pretty difficult to tame, because they're a passive tame. But I don't know. I'll look into it. I'll look into the most efficient way to get fertilizer. It might just be a bunch of those guys. Let's see, we have wood, we have gasoline, I'll toss it in there. Oh, I accidentally put seeds in. Let's see anything else that goes in there now. Did I put shark teeth in here? No, okay, good. Let's say go in here. Alright, let's see, they need polymer electronics, metal and cement and paste. Okay. I'm only gonna make two for now. Well, I can only make two at the moment. I don't think we should place them just yet, because they may get damaged by something flying by, and I don't really want it. Or actually, hang on. You know what? Yeah, I'm going to place them. It's just one less thing to think about. I won't load them up or turn them on, but I will place them now at least. Nope, can't quite make it. Maybe the backside. Yeah. Nope. Instead of giving myself a convenient... Oh god, don't move. Instead of giving myself a convenient way up, I have to bring a dinosaur around to jump on every time. Actually, no, I'm gonna center it. I think that'll look better. Alright, I see a wire connecting it. So that's good. And we have 24 slots for bullets. I'm thinking maybe 100 will do. If I'm raided in that time, then I can see and I'll refill the bullets. Oh god, I'm stuck. So I've been giving this guy all the experience potions I get so I can level him and number his melee damage since he can't really kill anything. Hopefully soon he'll actually have enough melee so he can kill stuff, and then I can start actually leveling him. I still think he can be helpful for taming, I don't know, maybe something small like direwolves and stuff like that. For Rexes, definitely a Drake would be better. But the small stuff, he could work for that. Now then, it's time to place these gates. As you can see, I have a lot of extra thatch walls and stuff, and roofs. Just in case I want to make any more structures. Okay, let's take a look at this. What would be the best places to put a behemoth gate? I'm thinking... one here by the... You know, by the furnaces, I don't think that'll work. How about on opposite ends where there's a lot of land, so you have to go on the land first? One over here, maybe. Let's place this down. That'll do. Now I just have to destroy all the pillars in the way. I'll do that off camera, though. And let's put one. I think over here. Oops, sorry about that. I have my phone right next to the microphone. I'll just quickly turn that off before all my friends start texting. If my phone will want to turn off, there we go. I'm also thinking... Oh, right here, since it snaps. Alright, so... I'll punch this down so I don't damage the wall. So, I'll start tearing down the pillars and everything in the way, and I'll continue with some tower building off-camera and stuff later on. So, thank you guys for watching, leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe for more videos like these, and yeah, see you guys.